While the storm clouds and winter months roll on along Brighton's seafront, new plans for the arches could mean a brighter future for the area. Brighton and Hove City Council have approved planning permission for some of the arches to be refurbished. As part of this refurbishment, new cafes, shops, huts and storage space will open along the seafront road. £5 million will be put into the King's Road arches, money that local businesses hope could improve the area, both for locals and tourists.
To my mind, anything that sort of modernises the beach and makes it more exciting place to go has got to be a good thing. The beach needs to move forward, and sometimes it feels a bit like it's sort of stuck in the 1980s, so anything that's sort of moving it forward is definitely, for my mind, a good thing.
The first phase of this regeneration started earlier in the year with 11 new shops opening near to the West Pier. They were built with an eye on 2016 and the opening of the I-360. The new shops were praised by the councillors at the time as fantastic and opened the door for further work to be done.
Anything that brings people down and stuff, and I think as well they're hoping to invest in other parts of the Brighton seafront, like the pier, the old pier. So yeah, anything that brings people down and regenerates the area is good. Yeah.
The Victorian arches are an iconic part of Brighton beachfront. Plans and building work began on them after many arches were found to be structurally unsound. The new plans will be finished by 2016, when the council is planning to open their refurbished seafront to the world.
We're absolutely delighted. It's going to increase the footfall, and I think just to increase the community of independent designers and makers, which have been here for years. We're thrilled.
New railings are also to be put above the arches. These are the designs that last 125 years and hopefully be as iconic as the arches they are on top of. The council granted planning permission on the 19th of November for these new facilities. The bars and shops will run from the I-360 site all the way along the coast to the Regency Square underpass. It's hoped that the work can start this year in time for the launch in 2016. This is James Lilywhite for Latest TV News.